So let's start with the swap partition. Linux device is physical RAM, which is a memory we called, okay, into the swap partitions. Is it correct? No. It's not that we are dividing the physical RAM for the swap partition. Basically, when the RAM is not enough to launch the application or to manage the current requirement of memory on the system, in that case, we need the swap partition. Let us understand, if we have the 4 GB of RAM and we have running multiple processes on the system, and 4 GB of RAM is not enough to serve all requests which we are getting on the operating system. In that case, operating system uses a memory of the hard disk as a RAM, and that memory we called as a virtual memory or the swap space. Alright. So basically, how the swap space works, because operating system understand there is a n number of processes which are running, but few processes might go on the sleep and few processes might running, right? The processes which are sleeping, it is not require any intervention. That process, operating system just move that process in the hard disk. And in the hard disk, where it's moved? In the virtual memory area, that is swap area, right? When the process need attention, that process again bring back into the main memory, that is a RAM. So we are moving processes from virtual memory to RAM and RAM to virtual memory, right? Because we do not have the enough space to handle all the processes in your physical memory, that is RAM. So this process we called as swap in and swap out. So swap out, any processes which is coming going for the hard disk is which called as a swap in, and any process coming out from the virtual memory to main memory we call as a swap out. So this swap in and swap out basically takes time, so you will lose some performance, because definitely you have to bring back that process into the main memory, and again you have to send into the hard disk, that is virtual memory. Definitely it takes time. So swap memory is not that good for the system based on the performance, but definitely to suffice the memory requirement, or maybe you do not want to invest immediately, in that case swap memory is good to use as a RAM, right? So if you ask, I have the 8 GB of RAM and I'm underutilized means I'm not using 100% of my RAM, maybe I'm using 60%. Do I need swap? Definitely no, as of now, looking at the situation, because I'm not using my RAM itself, then why I need the swap? So this is a common question. So every time we not require the swap, swap is required only if you feel your RAM is not enough to manage your application, to manage your system memory requirement, in that case swap is required. But for the safer side, every system at least some small amount of memory is configured as a swap, because we don't know, maybe in future more application is going to run on the system and the requirement is going to be huge. In that case, definitely let's keep the swap. Like for example, on my system, if we run the command free space h, it will show us here it's around 1.8 GB of memory, that is around 2 GB of memory, and out of it I have 2 GB of swap also, right? So I have 4 GB of memory, you can look at it another way, right? But definitely I am using, I have 1.0, around 1 GB memory is free. Definitely this memory is not going to be used. So if you can see here, 0 byte is used. Why 0 byte is used? Because I am not using main memory as a whole, then why I will use a swap? So once my main memory is consumed, after that this memory gonna utilization going to be started, all right? So this is how the concept is. Now we'll look that to check the swap space, right? So to check the swap space, we can easily run the command swap on hyphen s. So this show us here swap space. So this is my the file system or the device, and this is a size and this is a partition, right? So what is a partition type? Partition means one specific partition is given to my swap. In df-h we cannot see that, because why? The interesting thing about the swap, we do not need it to mount it and we do not need it to format it. That is very, very important. It's different from our normal partition, because for normal partition, we have to format it, we have to mount it. But for swap, it just you have to create it, that's it. We do not need to mount it. So therefore, we cannot see that swap partition in DF-NH. No, we cannot see that, right? And we do not format it in any file system. So it's a raw file system. It's not require any formatting, right? So that's the reason. When you add the partition, just add it to the swap, not require formatting, not require mounting, right? So that is how it's different from the normal partitions, okay? So what we are going to do, we are going to add one small hard disk, a separate hard disk or separate partition for the swap, and we'll create a swap, all right? Let us check if we have the space by using sfdisk-sh. So S is good enough. So here we can see that multiple devices are there, SDB, SDC, right? So we'll choose one of the device. So let's choose SDC. So fdisk, what we are going to do? We are going to create one small partition from this hard disk, SDC. All right. So we'll first do the print. So yes, there are the two partitions. So these two partitions, as of now, we do not require. It's not useful for us. So we'll delete it, partition one, and we'll delete it, partition two. Now we'll print the table. There is no partition. All right. Now we'll create a partition. For that, we'll give the command n to add a new partition, primary. Default is the first partition. That's fine. First sector starting. So it's starting from the 2048. That's fine. Keep it default. Now here we'll say plus 2G. We need 2GB of partition size. And we'll print the table. It's showing me here 2GB of blocks is created. So if you calculate this, it will come to 2GB, right? We'll save it and we'll come out. Now we have created a 2GB of partition. All right. Now if we run the lsblk, it shows here SDC1. SDC1 is our, which we have created. SDC is a hard disk. SDC hard disk size is 10GB. And out of it, we have created a 2GB of partition. All right. Now this is done. What next we have to do? As we discussed, we do not need to format it. So we got one partition /dev/SDC. So that partition need not to be formatted. Okay, now we directly go with the command mkswap. Mkswap stands for make swap partition. For which partition we have to create a swap? So we have to create SDC1, the partition of 2GB we have just created, right? It says setting up swap version 1 size is this. Now it has been set and there is a UID for this swap. So we have done with this. Now swap is created, but it's not activated. Okay. So what is mean by activated? Activated means it's not on. Okay. So if we see the command swap on -s. So here we are seeing that one swap is there. That is the existing one of 2GB, but our 2GB of swap is not added here. Right. So for that, we'll say swap on, and after that our partition name. So our partition is /dev/SDC. Now we'll check with the yes. So here we can see that one more 2GB of swap is added, right? If we give now free command, so here we can see it's become around 3.5, because earlier it was 1.5 and 2GB now got added. If we give here -h option, so that is human readable format. So here we can see now it's become 1.5 to it become now 3.5. Now you have enough swap space, more than your physical memory, right? So this is the one way to create the swap partition using the partition. What is mean by using the partition? You can create using the file also. That is our next goal. Okay. Thank you so much for watching.